On the go, WLWT News 5 Today starts now.
Well, good morning. Welcome to News 5 Today. Thanks for joining us on this Sunday. Good to be with you again. I'm Jonathan Hoggard. This is meteorologist Jennifer Shack, who's going to be carrying most of the water today because it's a severe weather Sunday.
Yeah, can't stress enough. We talk about severe weather a lot in the spring season. Mm-hmm. This is just as, let's say, alarming as a spring major severe weather system, but it's in the fall, and I think it might catch people off guard. So we need to make sure that they're very severe weather aware today. So okay. A pretty serious situation. We're not in the prime location for it. I think the most intense out of the system will be just to our west, but those storms will track across the tri-state after they develop. So let's get to our timeline. For people heading out this morning, it's already raining. It's already windy. You may start to question, well, what's the timeline today? We may have isolated severe activity ahead of the main line between about 9 a.m. and 2 p.m. We have chance for intense rain bands as some midday heating begins. We'll see some isolated thunderstorms, some isolated severe weather possibility. Between 2 and 5 p.m., that's our best chance for maybe a quieter window. Not to say there won't be isolated thunderstorms at that point, but if we're going to see some sunshine today and some drier periods, it would be between 2 and 5 p.m., which does align with the Bengals game. So keep that in the forecast in mind if you're heading to the Bengals game. Possibility of severe weather, but more than likely the quieter time period of the day. After 5 o'clock and until 9 o'clock this evening, that's our main event. We're talking widespread strong winds in excess of possibly 70 miles an hour and tornadoes a possibility. There will be the threat today for strong tornadoes. We're not just talking spin-up tornadoes or isolated tornadoes within a line of thunderstorms. We're talking supercells that merge together and may still keep some strong rotation. On the Power 5 radar this morning, we do have widespread rain out there already, and some of it is intense. Some of the red bands popping up already, 2-inch rainfall an hour marks, and so we're getting a good amount of rain for the morning. We have several more rounds of rain, so isolated flooding is also a possibility in the forecast today, and the winds are a concern. Beginning at 10 a.m. this morning, lasting through midnight, a wind advisory across the entire tri-state, southwest winds at 15 to 25 miles an hour, gusting to 50 miles an hour. So on the WLWT city cam, we have the rain out there for the morning. Visibility has dropped back just a touch. And here's what happened during the overnight. Some thunderstorms blossoming to the west become pretty intense. They have not issued any severe weather watches yet for the morning. They were contending with maybe down through Evansville, where it's been just a touch more intense. But I do not think we'll see a watch issued for the morning hours. Not to say we won't see some thunderstorms. There is some lightning mixed in, but this is mainly very heavy rain. It'll be filling in across the tri-state as we head through our morning. By 11 to noon, that's where the morning band begins to exit, and we get into that slightly dry, quieter period before the actual band of severe weather, the main event, comes in. About 5 to 6 o'clock this evening, you want to start to watch our western horizon for those storms to be arriving from the west. They'll initiate out along the Indiana-Illinois line, merge into a line of severe weather, and head right across the tri-state. Till about 8 or 9 o'clock this evening, our eastern counties will then be cleared, and we should all quiet down through the night. Here's the wind forecast with those strong south winds today ahead of the main line. Does a really nice job of showing when that band of severe weather will likely come in after 5 o'clock, sliding across the tri-state, and we are included again in that moderate risk for severe weather, but just to our west, they have been upgraded into a high risk for severe weather, and that's where the storms will initiate as supercells during the afternoon and then track across the tri-state for the late afternoon to early evening. The main threat for the system, again, is widespread damaging winds. Here's a close look at our future cast at 8 a.m. this morning. With the morning rain still around, then quieting down, starting to come to an end after 10 and 11 o'clock this morning, there's our better chance for that drier window where there's still some activity, but it's not as widespread. The main event coming in again after 5 o'clock this afternoon. Widespread damaging winds, our biggest concern in the forecast today. We also have that elevated tornado threat, and it is up in the alert area with isolated significant tornadoes or strong tornadoes a possibility. Hail and flooding also a concern for today's forecast. 62 for a high today. Windy even when there's not the severe weather, those strong south winds, 43 for a low tonight. And by tomorrow, we're at 69. Sunshine behind the system. Actually, tomorrow's forecast should say 49. Sorry about that. Beyond this, temperatures much cooler for the work week and pretty quiet. Some showers by Thursday and Friday. Jonathan.
Big